You have to strike the balance as well at university of studying versus socialising. So in university, you'll be bombarded with clubs, societies, groups that you can get involved in. And really, we are not going to tell you what to do. It's entirely up to you. If you want to spend all your time in these societies and in the bar, then that's entirely up to you. But at the end of the day, you have to make the decision about how you're going to strike the balance between studying and socialising. Now, what we understand is that you want to socialise, but we want to make sure that you do both. But that is entirely up to you. So that's an important thing that you have to think about and just get that balance right. And another challenge is that you're going to be working with lots of new people from lots of different backgrounds. So there may be nobody from your school on your course, or indeed even going to the university that you go to. That's a big scary thing to deal with. And you have to get involved with lots of different people, tutor groups, larger lecture size groups, the new societies you'll be involved in, and so on. And it's a really exciting time, but it's a very challenging time, and it's something that you need to be prepared for. What can you do to prepare yourself for the experience of studying psychology at university? Well, there's things you can do before you arrive, and then also once you arrive, there are other things that you can do really to get the best out of the experience. Before you arrive, speak to your teachers as much as possible. That's what they're there for. They're used to kids going off to university and studying psychology, so they have a good idea of what it takes to get the UCAS form right, and they have an idea of the different courses that are available as well. Take advantage of the open days that we have at universities. Come and speak to us, come and speak to our students, get a feel for the campus, the city and the environment that you're going to be in. From our point of view, it's really important that you have a sense that the place you are going to go is right for you. So you might go to a brilliant university, but you just don't have the right feeling about it. And unless you go on an open day, you're not going to know that. Also, speak to the admissions teams. So in psychology departments, we have admissions teams. We have people who can talk to you. They can discuss with you your A-level options. They can discuss what it takes to get into lead psychology, say. So we're here to talk to, and do take advantage of that. Also, the BPS website is very good, British Psychological Society website. So it's easy enough to Google British Psychological Society. The website has a wealth of resources that tell you all about courses in psychology, careers in psychology, and career paths. So that's a very useful website for getting you to appreciate what a psychology degree could equip you to do. Use resources like this, brilliant resource, fantastic range of podcasts on all different kinds of subjects. This will give you a really good idea of what it's all about, what psychology is all about, and about the kind of standards we're looking for from psychology students. So a resource like this, really excellent resource, and do maximise it. Okay, so that's things you can do before you arrive. What about when you get there? When you start university, what should you do to get the best out of it? Well, many universities run mentoring schemes, either within the psychology department or within the university union or within the university. If there are mentoring schemes, take advantage of them, because to have somebody in the second or third year of their degree who's looking out for you is a really nice thing in this big, scary place that you're going to be in. And they will give you lots of useful information and give you lots of help. So mentoring schemes are a great idea. Also, tutoring. You will be assigned a tutor. You may be assigned more than one tutor. We are here for you as you need us. So take advantage of the tutors. Don't feel shy to go to your tutor. That's their job. So make the most of the tutoring system. Support staff in universities and departments are useful as well. So there will be secretaries, there'll be people around the place. If the lecturers aren't available, then the secretaries are friendly and approachable people and will be ready to help you with any concerns you have. Most psychology departments have psychology societies as well. So this is a friendly bunch of students, student-led, student-run. The staff tend not to get involved too much. And it's a nice, friendly way to get to know lots of other psychology students and do some social stuff as well. So well worth joining PsychSoc. And also, most departments have student staff forums. So these are forums by which you can get your views heard. So if you've got an issue with your course, if you have concerns about your course, of course you can speak to your tutor, but more formally you can feed it through the student staff forum. So that's there for you to have your voice aired, so do make the most of it. So what are the top tips for success then? Well, first of all, it's blindingly obvious, but engage from day one. I think some students get a bit carried away with other stuff that's going on at university, and they think, well, you know, I don't have to go to lectures for the first few weeks, and I don't have to meet my tutor. These things are really important because they will make you feel confident that you are able and capable of doing this degree. And it's really important you meet your tutor and you start lectures from day one to build that rapport. So it's really important engaging right from the very beginning. Don't suffer in silence. If you're having problems, whatever kind of nature of the problems are, there are people at university to help. There are all kinds of support structures there. So don't struggle. Once we get you into the psychology programme, we will want you to succeed. And it's really important that you work with us and let us know if you're struggling. A kind of obvious one, but I think none of us do it as often as we should really. Use psychology in your learning. So you're going to be learning about learning, and you're going to be able to use these techniques and this knowledge base in order to become a better learner. So we know, for example, that being calm affords better learning. We know also from psychology that sleeping well affords better learning. And I think sleep is something that sometimes goes by the wayside when you're a student. So when you're learning about learning, think about how you can use that yourself to become a high achiever. Ask questions. Never feel scared to ask questions. Don't feel scared to put your hand up in lectures, to knock on your tutor's door. If there's anything you're not sure about, you can be guaranteed that somebody else won't be sure about it as well. So don't be afraid to ask questions. That's what we want. As I said earlier on, we want inquiring minds. So it's really important that you have that two-way dialogue with your tutors. And the last one, read, read, read. If you read, you'll be well prepared for your lectures, you'll be well prepared for your exams. Reading also gives you the experience of learning how people write well. So if you read material that's well written, it will help you to write better yourself. So reading is the ultimate key to success in a university psychology degree. So enjoy the experience of studying psychology at university. You won't be disappointed. It's the experience of a lifetime. And we'll see you soon.